All right, quick little video on puppy drive building. Some mistake I see people make in a Facebook fantasy land is the sexy misses. They have the flirt pole, they have the puppy out, and are making the dog miss after miss after miss. So the natural movement of this flirt pole is in a figure eight, right? So the dog goes out, they miss. They come back in, they miss. What the animal learns is, A, number one, my best effort doesn't get me paid negative punishment on the operant conditioning quadrant. And then what they learn to do is be lazy. They learn to sit in the middle and wait for the rabbit to come by and jump into the wolf's mouth, which is anti-nature. There is no suicide bunnies in nature that feel bad for the wolf or gonna jump in his mouth because he's starving. So what I like to use is a line. I have it on the puppy. I have the article out in front. I make forward movement, and at the last second, I slingshot the puppy into the target. As soon as they make the grip, I make tension on it. Start pulling it back and make it active. We do this repetitiously. I see it a lot. You're actually taking away the natural striking predatory behavior of the animal by doing this figure eight action where they get lazy sitting in the middle. All right, here's what I recommend you don't do first, all right? Miss. 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 You got it. He's quicker than I am. But again, they cross in front of you, they get lazy and they wait. You're actually punishing them for their best effort by not allowing to achieve it. Start with straight line, slingshot, boom. As soon as the dog slingshot into the article, make immediate tension with the stick and activate that rabbit. Fast, fast, fast target. Hey. Introduction to clatter sticks is at the end of the pole. So it's not intrusive. You've got all this distance to process this body language, process this noise, and I slowly work my way up. I'm not one of those guys that just goes right to work, seeing if it's a genetic roller coaster ride they can hang on for. I'll blade my body away so it's not intrusive again. Hey! 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 And as I'm making my approach, the stick is behind me. Okay, so I get in closer contact, the stick's behind me. Not a relevant deal. You notice it's behind me on the readjustment. If I went into the readjustment like this, it's too threatening. Put the stick behind me, make the readjustment, and do my work. Figure eight, straight lines. Again, you do your very best to continue the rag in a straight line so they can strike naturally, not having to move and miss. Yeah. And no. I won't be dunking him in water. He won't be going over fire. He won't be doing all kinds of X Games dumb shit. I'm going to let him be a puppy and enjoy life. I want to do a segment called Where Are They Now? Extreme puppy nonsense bullshit bite work. Social media superstar. get on the readjustment, I don't slip right away. The readjustment, the counter, the push creates activity. Active dog, reactive decoy. Everybody loves the misses. Everybody's out there trying to be sexy, social media, trying to be Ivan Balabanov. You're not him. I ain't him. And most people on the planet are nowhere near as talented as him. So do what you can with your skill set. But the most important thing here is not allowing the puppy to win through decreased effort. We have her start going, and we let her punch straight in. Always making tension once they grip. Everybody likes the sexy misses. The dog misses, the dog misses. It's actually negative punishment. The dog gives its best effort, and there's no paycheck. They learn to be lazy and wait in the middle for the figure eight to jump into their mouth. So we want fast striking. That prey attraction should go straight in. We use opposition reflex at the last second. Slingshot the line so the dog, the puppy enters the bite with every. Again, she's pursuing. Strike, right there. The second she hits, tension. Steady tension, capitalizing on opposition reflex. And if you notice there on the counter, on the push in, I didn't let her have it immediately. I want her to understand that pushing in and countering creates fight. A lot of fun, a lot of activity in the prey. If she counters in and I slip immediately, she can develop a little bit of a lazy mouth, push in and not have to grip harder. My introduction to sticks. Great distance. She's away from me here. And I show her the platter picture on the stick. Straight line. If you have the dog off leash, you're not using opposition reflex. Straight lines. Run from the dog with the article, with the rag, in a straight line so they work on that entry. Not the missing. They want their best effort to get rewarded. Step on the leash so she can't obtain it. Create a lot of frustration. That's a girl. Again, my floor pole can act as a stick as well. Get used to desensitizing, touching the puppy everywhere.